You're gonna need a bigger boat.
Hello, my friends, and once again, welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'll be your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we're talking about the kings of the water, great white sharks. Make sure you are subscribed to the channel and ring that bell so you can always be notified when we post videos. And as always, I encourage you to drop us some questions below for a chance to get the answers you so desperately want. I'll also be replying to some comments from a previous video at the end of this one, and recommend you check out some of our other shark-related questions if you enjoy this one. Today we'll be answering the question, what if great white sharks doubled in size? As of now, the biggest great white shark to have ever been captured on camera is called Deep Blue, and she's about 20 feet long. There were unconfirmed reports dating back to the 1870s and 1930s of sharks reaching close to 40 feet, but in 1970 it was confirmed the 36-foot shark reported back in 1870 turned out to be 16.4 feet in length, and a mistake was made in the original report. In regards to the 1930s report, many believe it was a misidentified basking shark, which looks similar to great whites in regards to their shape of their bodies. As of this recording, the largest confirmed great white sharks varies depending who you ask. Many reports believe the Cuba shark of 1945 was 20 feet and around 7,000 pounds, but after analysis of the photo by experts including R. Aidan Martin, who's a part of the ReefQuest Center for Shark Research, it turns out the shark was closer to about 16 feet as well. Its weight was hard to determine based off of a photo. Other photos have claimed great whites are sized up to 21 feet, but again, imagery is very tough to determine the legitimate size of something. So, to date, the largest 100% confirmed great white shark is Deep Blue, who was caught on video and comes in at 20 feet and about 5,000 pounds. But what if we had a 40-foot, 10,000-pound shark roaming our waters? Well, for starters, not all sharks would be that large. Deep Blue is actually an anomaly, as most sharks average to be around 15 feet in length and closer to 4,000 pounds. It also depends on the sex of the shark. Males tend to be slightly smaller than females, averaging around 11 to 13 feet in length. But let's say on average, if sharks were to double in size, they'd be about 30 feet in length and around 8,000 pounds. What would that mean for the entire ecosystem of the ocean? Well, truthfully, not a whole lot would change. The only real known threat to great white sharks is the killer whale, which can grow up to 36 feet in length and 12,000 pounds, or be as small as 16 feet and 3,000 pounds. Still pretty big, but compared to the biggest ones, you get it. If anything, having great white sharks double in size would just reduce the likelihood of killer whales attacking great whites, and it's believed they don't really go after them all that often. Although a recent study showed that killer whales have an appetite for great white shark livers, yes, specifically their liver, they also feed on seabirds, squids, octopus, sea turtles, other sharks, rays, fish, and seals. Killer whales are only hunted by humans, which we should stop that, because why? So to say that the biology of the ocean would change might be a stretch, but if great whites were to grow as big as killer whales, maybe they would include them in their diet as well. It's unlikely though, because like most animals, great whites tend to go for fish smaller than they are. Why make it harder on yourself to eat, kind of thing? With all this being said, it is fair to say that great whites would consume double the amount of fish they currently do. Assuming they were to double in size, I think it's safe to say their appetite would also double. This could be seen as problematic, because certain fish populations, more specifically we'll use seals, for example, could see a decrease in their numbers. Of course, as I'm sure you've heard in some previous videos on this channel, when the populations of certain animals take a blow, it affects the entire ecosystem. The loss of one species can cause a ripple effect of other species eventually going extinct because they lose their food source. Here's why I don't think it happened here though. Being the top predators, even if great whites doubled their appetite, I think there's enough resources for the ocean to continue to thrive. More specifically, the seal population declining wouldn't mean great whites starve. When food would start to become scarce, the sharks would migrate elsewhere, and the seals would eventually increase in numbers again, if not overpopulate, because the sharks wouldn't be hunting them in the first place. However, other species could be affected, following the example just mentioned. If great whites endangered seals, for example, and then migrated elsewhere to find an area where food is more plentiful, the species that seals eat, such as crustaceans and other fish, like salmon and herring, could see a big increase in their population. That is, until the seals even out their population. But seals are also known to overeat, so this may in fact actually be a good thing. But how could the doubling of size of great whites affect us as humans? Aside from the scientific research we'd have to do to figure out how they're growing so large, it really wouldn't be all that bad for us either. Although it seems people have this notion that great white sharks love to attack humans, thanks Spielberg, which also isn't necessarily true, yes, there have been, of course, both provoked and unprovoked attacks of great whites on humans all over the world. But in 2018, there were only 130 total attacks, with just over half, literally, 66 to be exact, being unprovoked according to the Florida Museum of Natural History. But being unprovoked could be a surfer wiping out near shark-infested waters, or splashing near them, which makes them believe there is possible food around. Overall, 130 shark attacks in a calendar year really isn't concerning, considering how many people are swimming in the ocean on a regular basis. So to say if sharks were to double in size, there'd be more attacks, I can't 100% deny that, but I think it's unlikely. Sharks can already make a meal of us if they wanted to, so them doubling in size really doesn't change all that much. So to wrap up, if great white sharks were to double in size, it may cost us a few $100 million to do some research on them, if that even, and find out what's causing them to grow so large, which could be a whole other issue in itself. But we wouldn't be affected all that much, nor really see a change in anything, really. Thankfully, it doesn't seem like sharks are doubling in size anytime soon, and even if they did, just stay away from them. I mean, you wouldn't like it if a shark showed up one day in the middle of your house, would you? How do you think they feel?
Jellyfish!
And on that note, let's reply to some comments from the video. What if Pennywise the Clown was real? Sarah Oldford said, "My only fear is that Mai might reject me." Sarah, who hurt you? Why would the clown reject you? I mean, if that's your fear, then he probably would, but then you don't have to worry about it because he won't even come near you, so don't worry. I'm sure you'll find someone great. Pandanini said, "If Pennywise can turn into our fears, he can't get me. What's it going to turn into? Student loans?" I don't think I've ever related so much to a comment on YouTube. Like, literally, it would just be like a number chasing me around, and I'd be like, "Listen, you're the death of me anyways as is, so you might as well finish the job." Matthias' vlog story said, "If Pennywise was real, I would hire the New York Giants to take him out." Well, I hate to break it to you, but the Giants can't even seem to beat any NFL team, so the odds of them beating an evil entity like Pennywise the Clown, it's not happening anytime soon. And on that note, guys, I'm going to wrap this one up by saying go Eagles, they're going to win the division. I've been your host, Jared Bronson. You guys have been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you're a Cowboys fan or a Giants fan, let me know in the comments down below so I can make fun of you. Redskins, we already beat you guys, so that's irrelevant. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Share it with a friend. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you guys soon.